this guy will take one. You tell him to take one with my wife and I? Mm-hmm. Can you get one with my wife and I?
Of course. Sure.
It's on that HDR mode, and so you just hold it pretty still and hit that button, and it'll take three shots, so.
All right.
Where are you? Here. Where are you? Here. You might flip it for it. That's right, like you might just flip it vertically. Yeah. Perfect.
We do it again.
Okay, it takes a second because what it's doing is it's aligning all three, and now it'll go again. One more time.
You ready?
Yeah. Thank you.
Hopefully that'll be a good one.
I think so. This is it. When it's a cool feature on the camera, it blends the three.
Oh wow, yeah.
So yeah, that's a good job.
Chop off their head.
Right? Woo, woo,
woo. Nice camera.
What's that?
Nice camera.
Yeah, that's a fun camera.
Good camera.
Yeah. Thank you. Jamie, did you get your glass ball? Can you get back to out front? There it is. That one too. You get whatever you want, but those are pretty. Nope, not that much. Thank you.
And the first architect was Fire. But the problem was the ground of Pisa, the marshy ground, very rich of water. So the soil was too wet, too soft, and the tower was very heavy. As you can see, in fact, it's totally built with marble, and the total weight is more than 14,000 tons. So the works were immediately interrupted until they were resumed just 100 years later with an artist called Giovanni di Simone, who tried to correct the mistake. Giovanni, from this point, added the new floors with one side taller than the other, just in order to counterbalance the inclination to shift the center of gravity. In fact, the tower from this point seemed to be straight, and the shape for this reason recalled banana shape. The tower was finally finished during the second half of the 14th century with the top, but during the centuries continued to sink very slowly into the ground. So in 1990 it was totally closed in order to fix it and reduce the inclination. The main intervention was to remove the battery of grids more than 70 tons of earth from underneath the foundation while supporting the tower with steel cables, counterweights. In this way they reduced the overhang slope by about 46 centimeters. And nowadays it's totally fixed and stable. Okay, the height is 58 meters. There is just one staircase with about 260 steps. All around the top floor you can see seven large bells, which are still used, because the Leaning Tower is just the bell tower of the main church of Pisa. Okay, the last curiosity. This tower is also famous thanks to Leonardo Galilei, the great scientist and mathematician who was born in Pisa, because according with the tradition, Galileo, from the top of the tower, dropped different objects in order to discover the level of gravity. But actually, it's not the truth. It's just a legend. He never did this kind of experiment from the top of the tower. Okay, thank you for your attention and enjoy your visit. Thank you.
Come back here. Start walking up the stairs. Thank you.
going around and around up there.